Join us now for Bible Tract Echoes. This program is the radio ministry of Bible Tracts Incorporated, founded in 1928 by evangelist Paul Levine and dedicated to getting the gospel of Jesus Christ to the whole world. Here today with a special message from God's Word is Mark Smith. Mark is the director of Bible Tracts Incorporated. And now, our Bible teacher, Mark Smith.
Hello, my friend. Thank you for joining me on the broadcast today. My Bible is open to the book of Acts, Acts chapter 20. Join me there if you can. Today will be a different day, a different kind of day. Today I am going to break from our study in the Gospel of Matthew because I want to honor godly dad, my dad. Today is my dad's 92nd birthday. My invitation to you is very simple. I invite you to listen as I have this opportunity to personally honor and praise my dad. I'm going to do that by opening the Word of God to Acts chapter 20. Frankly, this will be the passage that I will use one of these days if the Lord tarries his coming at his funeral. I will have the privilege of preaching my dad's funeral. Now, what passage of God's Word fits your life, my friend? Hopefully, it would be hard for you and me to limit ourselves to one passage of the Word of God. But if you had to do just that, what Bible passage would you like to be the one that really just kind of fit your life hand in glove? I'm going to use Acts 20 to honor my dad. I do that, and I pray that we will be challenged along the way and how we are living our lives for him. While you're getting your Bible open to the book of Acts in chapter 20, I just simply invite you to contact us. Bible Tracts Echoes is the radio site of Bible Tracts Incorporated, and we have been nudging you this week in particular to get ready. If you're one that likes to use gospel tracts in your Christmas cards that you send out, this is the right time to get a hold of us and say, I need some Christmas tracts. We have one track in particular called The Gift that really works well. Two others work very, very well also, but the track The Gift has a picture of a present right on the front, beautifully wrapped. It just really fits to use at Christmas time in a very unique way. We give tracts away all over the world. We print tracts in many different languages and give them away. We pay the shipping and everything. Let us be a partner with you. Now, at the end of the broadcast, our mailing address will be given, but that's all that's going to be given at the end of the broadcast. If you would like to contact us by telephone, let me give you that phone number right now. I hope you're ready to jot it down. You can contact us here at Bible Tracts by calling area code 309-828-6888. One more time, that phone number is area code 309-828-6888. If you'd like to use your computer, you can contact us by going to our website, which is BibleTractsInc.org. All right, the Inc. is spelled INC, short for Incorporated, BibleTractsInc.org. Or if you'd like to just email us, it is BibleTractsInc@juno.com. Okay, so you come here to Acts and chapter 20. Most of you will already realize that this is a passage concerning the Apostle Paul, and he's having a preacher's conference. By the way, my dad's name is Roscoe Smith. He is now living in Dayton, Illinois. At this point in his life, he is experiencing some of those natural aspects of being 92 years of age. The most notable thing about that he is dealing with right now deals with his short-term memory. It's very difficult for me to carry on a conversation. I'm just one of six children. For us to carry on a conversation of even 15 minutes is difficult because his mind simply cannot follow the details of the conversation. Oh, but if you could have just seen my dad 40 years ago. Now, 40 years ago would have made me 13 years of age. I got to play softball in a church softball league with my dad and so on. My dad at that point in time was always, his mind was sharper than a tack, and details were his specialty. He was really good with math and figures and budgets. He would figure out somebody's tax up in his head that he would owe the IRS. He could do that in his head and come within pennies. He really was really sharp. And so for me and my family to see him his short-term memory being so short, it's a difficult thing for us. But God saved my dad from his sin when he was in his 20s. He was already married. Then in his early 30s, God called my dad to the gospel ministry. My dad has pastored churches in the state of New York, in the state of Illinois, in the state of Indiana, and in the state of Alaska. I have learned more theology, more practical skills for living the Christian life from Roscoe Smith than I have from any other person, frankly, from two or three other people combined. There is so much going through my mind right now that would be right and fitting for me to share as I think about and remember my dad. But our Bibles are open to Acts chapter 20, aren't they? Let's let God's Word do the talking for us right now. I'm going to jump into the middle and the end part of here, this whole pastor's seminar. The Apostle Paul has gathered the pastors, the church leaders here at Ephesus together for a seminar. Paul knows he will never see them again. I begin reading at verse 28. Take heed, therefore, unto yourselves and to all the flock over which the Holy Ghost hath made you overseers, and feed the church of God, which he hath purchased with his own blood. For I know this, that after my departing shall grievous wolves enter in among you, not sparing the flock. Also of your own selves shall men arise, speaking perverse things, and drawing away disciples after them. Therefore watch and remember that by the space of 3 years I cease not to warn everyone night and day with tears. And now, brethren, I commend you to God and to the word of his grace, which is able to build you up and to give you an inheritance among all them that are sanctified. I have coveted no man's silver or gold or apparel. Yea, and ye yourselves know that these hands have ministered unto my necessities and to them that were with me. I have showed you all things, how that so laboring ye ought to support the weak. And remember the words of our Lord Jesus, how he said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. And when he had thus spoken, he kneeled down and prayed with them all. And they all wept sore and fell upon Paul's neck and kissed him, sorrowing most of all for the words which he spake, that they should see his face no more. And they accompanied him unto the ship. This is a great passage of Scripture dealing with the departure of a great godly servant. Now, I chose it a couple of years ago to use at my dad's funeral, and he knows it, by the way. I've talked to him about this very passage and how I want to use it. So he knows all about this. I'm not telling tales out of school one iota. As I said, Acts 20 is a pastor's conference, and the Apostle Paul is saying goodbye to these pastors and church leaders. These pastors were not going to see Paul again this side of glory. The hearts of both the pastors and Paul, frankly, are laid open to us, and we are allowed to see inside, particularly Paul's heart. Let me tell you why these verses fit my dad. There are seven things I want to share that come out of this passage that fit my dad. Then tomorrow I want to come back and really kind of march through the passage a little more typically. But number one, my dad was always a mentor of other preachers. I know of twice I got to watch my dad on a Monday morning for a series of months. There was pastors, this has happened two different times that I know of. There are men who had been called to the ministry. They're pastored in the area near to my dad, but they'd never had the opportunity to have formal pastoral training. Now, they had college education, but they were never trained in theology, trained in being a pastor. They would come over every Monday, and my dad was their teacher. They had books they would use, and my dad just flat out mentored them. These men that Paul's talking to here, these are men that he had mentored. He had led probably many of these men to Christ himself. Paul was a mentor of men. My dad is a mentor of men. Dear pastor, are you listening to me? Are you and I mentors of men? Men, whether they're going to be pastors or not, men in our churches, men for our families, we need to be mentors of men. Secondly, my dad was a warner and an encourager of other preachers. Verse 28 says, take heed to yourselves. Verse 31 says this, therefore watch and remember that by the space of 3 years I cease not to warn everyone night and day with tears. My dad was a person who, when around other pastors, warned them and encouraged them and challenged them and confronted them. By confront, I don't mean he confronted them about their life. He would come alongside and confront them. How are you doing in your devotional life? How are you doing loving your own wife? How are you doing with your family? He would do that. Oh, what an example he was to me. Thirdly, my dad was a strong urger of others to lean on the grace of God. Verse 32, great verse. He says, and now, this is Paul saying to these preachers, and now, brethren, I commend you to God and the word of his grace. My dad believes in, understands, and is lived by the grace of God. Saving grace, yes, but that was in his 20s. Oh, supplying grace. And my dad is living by the grace of God at 92 years of age, knowing that while he comprehends that his mind cannot follow and have his mind work like it once did, but he knows he is serving God even today by the grace of God. Oh, my friend, we need to grab hold of the multifaceted grace of God to meet our needs. Number four, my dad knew he was serving not for this world, but for the next. Verse 32 says, and now, brethren, I commend you to God and the word of his grace, which is able to build you up, and listen now, and give you an inheritance among all them that are sanctified. My dad, the old song, this world is not my home, I'm just a passing through. The mansions are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. My dad knew that and lived for that, and my dad knew very, very well his rewards were not this side of glory, that godly pastors have an inheritance that's very special and unique. Oh, my friend, whether you're a pastor or not, we all need to be living not for this world, but for the next. Number five, my dad was never in the ministry for money. Verse 33, Paul says, I didn't covet anybody's money or gold, silver, or clothing. My dad worked hard to serve other people in their spiritual needs and in their physical needs. Sixthly, my dad so touched lives that when God would lead my dad to leave one church and go to another, the people in the church that he was leaving would literally weep sorely and did not want he and my mom to leave. Oh, what an example of a man who touched lives, ministered to lives, cared for lives so much so that they felt they were losing, pardon if I could use this well, their spiritual dad. Oh, we have a heavenly father. My dad would just no way, shape, matter, or form want to be misconstrued as being their spiritual father. But he was their leader. He was their pastor. He was their heartbeat. He was their carer. And these people, my dad knew how to minister to people. Number seven, my dad is a praying man. My dad prayed. My dad, I saw him pray. I heard him pray. I saw him teach about prayer. I saw him stop in the middle of day. I saw him stop in the middle of a row of corn and stop and pray. My dad prayed for people. Oh, what a role model I had for ministry. My friend, you and I need to be men and women who touch the lives of others and impact them in such a way that they would grieve over our losing us to their lives. God help us to be impacting the lives of others today. Would you please today thank God for Roscoe Smith on his 92nd birthday, that he lives a life pleasing to God.
We're glad you've joined us today for Bible Tract Echoes. Be sure to send your letter of encouragement today, or you may request Bible Tracts. Simply write us at Bible Tracts Incorporated, Post Office Box 188, Bloomington, Illinois, 61702. That's Bible Tracts Incorporated, Post Office Box 188, Bloomington, Illinois, 61702. And thank you for being with us today on Bible Tract Echoes. May God richly bless you.